This is the first in a series of videos exploring arrays in Delphi. In this video, we will look at these topics. I will first explain what arrays are. Then we will look at the purpose of arrays. I will show you code snippets with and without arrays. Then I will explain different types of arrays in Delphi programs. I will show you how and where you can declare arrays. Then we will learn different ways to assign values to arrays. After that, I will explain how to read and process the values you stored in an array. Finally, we will do a simple project to practice all these concepts. Hi, it's Gerard here from LearnDelphi. I'm a trainer in programming languages, and in this series, I help you to understand Delphi programming step by step and line by line. If this video is helpful to you, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And I also published all the links I mentioned in this video in the description box below. In all our lessons, I start with the code immediately. I do not demonstrate how to create the graphical user interface. This is so that you only focus on the code of the lesson we are doing. But if you want to follow what I'm doing and you want to save some time, you can download the graphical user interface to start immediately where I start with this lesson. The starter and solution project files are available for download from my Patreon page at patreon.com/learndelphi. I also posted that link in the description. And I'm using Delphi 10.3 Community Edition to demonstrate these lessons. There's also a link in the description if you want to download a free copy of Delphi. You can pause the video here, go do the downloads, and while you are getting ready to do the project with me, I'm going to explain arrays. Arrays are ordered collections of data of one type. In past lessons, we declared many variables. Some of them were numbers, like integers and floating point numbers. Some were booleans, strings, dates, and so on. You learned that these variables are storing values of a specific type in memory. An array is also a data structure that stores values in memory. An array is also declared like a variable. It has a name and it has a data type. An array can also be scoped locally for a specific subroutine or globally for the whole class. But unlike a variable, an array can store more than one value in memory at a time. So why do we need arrays? Consider the following scenario. You declare a string variable named strmonth. Later in your code, you assign January to strmonth. And then you read the value in strmonth and display it in a listbox component. The listbox will display January, but a string variable can only store one month's name. If you try to also assign February after you assign January, you will kick the first value out of the variable and overwrite it with February. So there's no way to know what was in strmonth before you assigned a new value. To store all the month's names in memory, you can declare 12 string variables, like this. Now there's 12 individual strings in memory. Then you must assign a month's name to each of those placeholders in memory. Doing this, you do not have to kick out or overwrite existing values you saved in memory. Then you must also add the values in the variables to the list box, one per line. But there's a few problems with this approach. First of all, your code becomes cluttered. Secondly, if you want to do additional processing on all the month names, like formatting them all to uppercase letters, you must do it one at a time. In other words, each individual variable must be passed to the uppercase function. Thirdly, the month names are not in a particular order. There is no way for the compiler to know, for example, that March follows February, or that December is the last month. With an array, you can remove the clutter, process all the months in one statement, and keep track of the order of the month names. In the next few lessons, we will learn about several types of arrays. Today, we will start with single-dimensional arrays. A single-dimensional array only stores an array of values that describe one thing, like all the names of the month or all the first names of students. So it is like storing a list of values in memory. The items in a list box or a field in a database table can be considered single-dimensional arrays. Later in this series, we will also learn about two-dimensional arrays. Using a two-dimensional array is like storing more than one small array in one big array. An entire database table with more than one field, or a spreadsheet with multiple columns and rows, or calendars, can all be considered multidimensional arrays. Now let's see how you declare an array. Today we will only explore single-dimensional arrays. Arrays are called arrays because it stores an array of variables in memory. So you also declare arrays where you declare variables, and their scopes are the same as the scopes of variables. They can be declared above the begin statements of procedures and functions, if they must only be accessible locally. Or they can also be declared under the implementation clause, if you want to share them between subroutines in the same unit. You can even declare an array as a constant, if the values always stay the same. Just like variables, you must provide a descriptive name for your array. I see in some school manuals you are instructed to use ARR as a prefix for your name. In these lessons, I will use ARR as the prefix for an array. But with most programming teams I worked with in the past, we use the same prefixes we use for declaring variables, like str for strings and int for integers. But to make a distinction between variable and array names, a general convention is to use singular nouns for variables, like strmonth, and plural nouns like strmonths or arrmonths for arrays. You must use what your school or your team prescribes. The name is followed by a colon, which means as, and then it is followed by the word array. Then we add square brackets after the word array, and between the square brackets we define the size of the array. The size is how many data items of the same type you want to store in the array. For the 12 months in a year, you will specify 1 to 12 by separating 1 and 12 with two dots. Then that is followed with the data type. For example, month names are strings, so this array stores 12 values, from 1 to 12, and the array is of type string. Now all 12 values in the array must be strings. With arrays, you can't mix it up and store strings, integers, booleans, dates, and so on in one array. Now this is like grouping the 12 variables we saw earlier into one big data structure, with one name instead of 12. So we will reference all the months by the same name, in this case, ARR months. Each item in the array is called an element. To make a distinction between elements, Delphi assigns a number to each element. That number is called an index. This array stores elements 1 to 12, so the first element will have an index of 1, and the rest will follow in an ordinal sequence, up to index 12. The lowest number in this range is 1. That is called the lower limit or the lower bound of the array. The highest number, in this case 12, is called the upper limit or the upper bound of the array. Now let's see how you assign values to each element. All of the elements use the name ARR months, but we reference them by adding their index numbers behind the name between square brackets. Now the array's elements will contain 12 individual month names. You can also initialize the elements of an array when declaring it, like this. After the declaration, you add the list of month names by assigning them immediately. You must use an equal sign. This assignment is not done with colon equals. Then you list the elements between round brackets, separated by commas. You must list them in the order you want to store them. The array will automatically assign an index to each element from 1 to 12 in the order you type them. So January will be 1, February 2, and so on. Another way to populate elements of an array is to read values from text files and then to assign each value to an element in the array. But more about that when we explore text files later. After assigning values to the elements of your array, you can read, process, and output the elements. To read an individual value, you must reference the name of the array with the index of the specific element you want to extract. This statement will pick element 3 out of the array. Element 3 stores March, so you can now process or output that individual value. The elements of an array are indexed with integer numbers in an ordinal sequence. You learned before that ordinal types are integers or characters that follow each other in a predictable and consistent sequence. You also learned that we can loop through ordinal types. So if you want to do the same thing with all the elements in your array, you can loop through the indices of the array, and your loop will cycle and process each element one by one during each cycle of the loop. Notice how I use the counter variable of this for loop as the index of the array between square brackets. Every time the loop increments int index, the next element in the array is found and listed in the list box. Now let's look at a simple project that uses an array. If you downloaded the starter files from patreon.com/learndelphi, you must now open it in your copy of Delphi and do the project with me. If you want to create the user interface yourself, you can just observe how I created and named my components and try to mimic mine. Here's how it looks. Today we will only program this part. The user must select a month number from the spin edit. The min value of the spin edit is 1 and the max value is 12. As the user selects or types a number in the spin edit, the name of the month with that number must display in the panel. We will populate these two list boxes in the next video. Let's get our hands dirty. Double click the spin edit. This event handler will immediately execute every time the value changes. Go above begin. Type var. Press enter and type ARR months as array 1 to 12 of string. ARR months is an array with 12 elements that are indexed from 1 to 12, and each element is of type string. Press enter, type int month number as integer. This integer will read the number you selected in the spin edit. Go under Begin, type ARR months, and behind the name, type 1 between square brackets, followed by a colon equals January. You assign January to the first element of the array, so January's index will be 1. Enter and assign a value to index 2 like this. Now copy this line and paste it 10 times on separate lines. Then change the indices in sequence. Then assign the month names to each element in sequence. Great! This is now like having 12 variables with a common name, grouped into one big data structure in memory. Make a new line and type int month number colon equals sed month number dot value. Here we read the value the user selected in the spin edit and assign it to int month number. Make a new line and type this statement. For now, we only retrieve the name of the month that has an index of 12. Then we assign it to the caption of the panel. Index 12 is December, so no matter what the user selects, December will always show. Run the application. Select or type a number in the spin edit. December displays immediately in the panel. Close the form. Here we assigned the number the user selects in the spin edit to an integer called intMonthNumber. So we can use intMonthNumber to indicate by index which element must be picked out of the array. Replace the 12 between square brackets with intMonthNumber. Run the program again. The default number in the spin edit is 1, but the panel doesn't display January when the program starts up. We can fix that in several ways, but first select a few other numbers in the spin edit and make sure you get the correct month names. Select 1 again. Now January shows in the panel. January doesn't show when the program starts because we coded the onChange event of the spin edit. And when the form is created, the spin edit hasn't changed yet. Let's fix it and try again. Close the form. Click the Design tab. Select the spin edit. Go to the Object Inspector and look for the spin edit's value property. Make the value 2. Now double click a blank space on the surface of the form. This event handler will be executed when the form is created in memory. Type this statement between begin and end. Here we change the spin edit's value back to 1. The onCreate event is one of the first events that is triggered when the form starts up. So here we can set the first value of the spin edit back to 1. Then the form's onCreate event will in turn trigger the spin edit's onChange event, which will then pick January from the array. There is some other ways you can also do this, but this is an easy hack to solve the problem. Let's see if it works. Run the project. Now January displays when the form starts up. And all the other elements are also picked out of the array and displayed as we change the number. Close the form and save your project. In the next video, we will complete this project. We will populate these two list boxes with array elements using a loop. If you had fun, please leave a comment. And if you learned something new, please like, subscribe and share my lessons with your friends. Thank you for watching. And a special thank you to my supporters on Patreon.com. Happy coding. See you next time. We'll